everyone, and welcome to Art Smart. Today we're going to be talking about a revolutionary film, Kid Otto Races at Venice. Now, this was the very first of the Charlie Chaplin Tramp films. You're going to watch it, and probably you're going to think to yourself that this is not really an outstanding film or something that stands out as like this revolutionary type of thing. And you may wonder why this is a big deal. But if you just kind of listen a little bit, I'm going to tell you some tidbits about it that might make it a little bit more obvious why this particular film is a landmark in the history of cinema. Now, this film came out in 1914. To put that in perspective, this came out at the very same time, or around the same time, as D.W. Griffith's The Birth of a Nation. That is a very famous film, and while it's famous for both its grand epic battles and wonderful cinematography, you may also know it because of its disregard for the black race and all kinds of just negative images of African Americans. So that film is kind of notorious for both good and bad things, and I think it's notorious for good reasons in both the good and bad direction. But keep in mind that that was happening right around the same time as this. So this particular film is just as revolutionary, and it was coming out at a time when different filmmakers were really kind of figuring out how to make a film. This particular example shows one of the first times that you have mugging for the camera, which was definitely a new thing for actors to be trying to do. Before this, a lot of the time people had the idea that the camera should not be acknowledged at all, that the camera was just kind of sitting there and watching almost in a passive way what was happening in front of it. This particular film, you see Charlie Chaplin mugging the camera and trying to get on it. He's playing this tramp character, which was very much an everyman, and the everyman wanted to be in front of the camera, which was this new and exciting thing, trying to show off in front of it, trying to talk about themselves or show themselves in front of the camera. It was a very new thing that was happening throughout Hollywood, and the tramp character here is really no different than your average person. So he's definitely making fun of the average person here, but also kind of celebrating that kind of person by making this film. One thing that you may not know is this is an early example of a film that's being made during a real-life event where most of the people that were there were not actors. Quite simply, they were setting up the camera and having Charlie go around an actual race and kind of cut in and in front of it and actually step in front of actual spectators and interact with them. Today, you see characters like Borat on films do that kind of thing quite often. But that is not a new thing at all. It was being done well over 100 years ago here by Charlie Chaplin. This also should be noted as a film where he is kind of figuring out what the tramp character was going to be. The tramp would kind of become more of a sweet and gentle character that was disregarded by society over time. During the first few films, the tramp character was really more kind of a everyman that was kind of getting in the way and was a little bit more selfish, I think is a good way of describing him. So he's kind of figuring out what the tramp was going to be here. But you definitely have the getup that he made right from the beginning. Now, if you haven't heard a whole lot about the tramp character, you should know that it was created by him simply going into the dressing room and trying on different clothes and trying to find the most contrasting clothes that he could find. He wanted a very tight, small hat. He wanted a small jacket, but he wanted these big, baggy pants that had to be tied by a rope and didn't fit him, a shirt that was hanging too long, shoes that were floppy. He wanted the character to just be a juxtaposition in all of his clothing from top to bottom. And you can definitely see that here in this character. He also decided to start wearing that little mustache A lot of people don't realize that Chaplin did not actually have a mustache. This was a fake mustache, and a lot of film actors at that time would add the mustache, especially in comedy, in order to make their character stand out a little bit more in these early black and white films, to kind of give their face a little bit of contrast. I definitely enjoy in this film watching the Chaplin character just kind of mugging in front of the camera and getting in the way. It could be a little annoying if it's in real life, but here he's kind of making fun of real life people. And I enjoy the fact that he keeps looking back at the camera and trying to get our attention. And it seems very natural and very real to what people actually kind of do. If you watch the news and you see the camera talking about something very serious and you have people trying to jump in front of the camera and get the attention, it happens to this very day. So I think this is a film that really gets into the psyche of what people were, especially in the early days of cinema. I think that it was a new, subtle form of comedy. It was also just a very new character that he was trying out, and in later films, the Tramp character would become more and more polished. And in general, I just think if you compare it to a lot of films made around this time, it's very good. So anyway, have a great day, and make sure you continue to art smart.